For more on the situation in Haiti tonight, we turn to NPR's Jason Beaubien, who joins us by telephone from Port-au-Prince. Jason, this is quite a remarkable development, a turnaround. Do we know any reason tonight why really Jean-Claude Duvalier came back?
We really don't. Everyone today was expecting that Jean-Claude Duvalier was going to give a press conference. One of his aides came out and basically said there wasn't a big enough room at the hotel. It was really quite strange because clearly they could have just done it out front. It seems like a little bit of a stall, really, in terms of providing information about why he's here. His people officially are saying that he's back as a private citizen. He's here, they say, to help with the reconstruction. But clearly the timing of this is incredibly strange. I mean, that is sort of the biggest shocker of this. In the midst of a political crisis, to have such a powerful person in Haitian history, in recent Haitian history, return, someone who's so controversial, some people absolutely love him. Other people make out that he's practically the devil. So it's an incredibly polarizing figure to have come back at a time that the country is trying to figure out who's going to be the next president.
You're right, but it seems that there were people at the airport to greet him. There were cameras that recorded his arrival. Was it that much of a surprise that he came back?
It really was a surprise. There were all those people at the airport because the word went out on the radio that he was on a plane. At first, it just seemed like rumors that he was coming on this Air France jet, but the word got out, and it was on the local radio, and people just rushed down there. And so those people that were there were very much his supporters. But even amongst the elite, when you talk to sort of the social elite, political elite here, people were really surprised. Clearly, the upper levels of the Haitian government knew this was going on. He was traveling on a Haitian diplomatic passport, so clearly the upper levels of the Haitian government knew. But it really seems like just about everybody else, this was the last thing in the world that they expected to happen to a country that's trying to deal with this earthquake, trying to deal with the cholera epidemic, trying to just figure out how this presidential election is going to move forward in the next phase. People were really quite surprised and shocked to hear that the baby doc was returning.
Given what we know about his history and the unprosecuted crimes he's accused of, where was he? And what happens now that he's back? Is he subject to still being pursued or prosecuted?
That's one of the big open questions at the moment. He's staying at one of the very nice hotels in Pétionville, a suburb just on the side of Port-au-Prince here. He was given a police escort. It's clear that he's being welcomed by the state here. At the same time, human rights groups are calling for him to be prosecuted, for him to stand charges for the crimes that were committed by his regime. It's completely unclear at this point what's going to happen with that, whether there will be an attempt to bring charges against him or not.
He looked kind of frail in the photographs that we saw. Do we know anything about the state of his health?
We really don't. And that's one of the reasons that it would have been nice to actually see him in a press conference, get a better sense of what's really going on. There are all kinds of rumors going around. Some people are saying he's gravely ill. Other people are denying that. Everyone's just reading the tea leaves at the moment, because he hasn't come out and given a statement and really addressed why he's here, what he's doing here, and sort of, you know, where things are going to go in the future, whether he's planning to jump into politics, whether he's going to be, as he says, just a private citizen visiting for a few days. Most people don't seem to believe that. They believe that he's come back and he's going to be here to stay. And the big question is, what role is he going to play in Haitian politics, or you know, what could happen to him himself? There are people whose families were killed, they say, by his regime, people who were tortured. And the question is, will people attempt to bring him before justice?
Jason, how much closer, this political standoff that's been going on, have there been any developments? Is it moving any closer to resolution?
It does feel like it's moving closer to resolution. The Organization of American States came out with a recommendation that Madame Maniga and Michel Martelly should be in the runoff, which is a change from what the Haitian government, the Haitian Electoral Commission originally said. So that report has gone to President Preval. We expect that we're going to get some sort of statement from him on whether or not he's going to accept that. But, you know, the second round of the runoff was supposed to be yesterday, and that just didn't happen. It's been postponed, as you said, indefinitely. So this could get dragged out for, weeks. We really don't know.
Well, Jason Beaubien, it's good to talk to you down there on the scene. We'll be in touch. Thanks.